Well, good evening, everyone. Welcome to First Baptist Church. We're so glad that you're here. What a joy and privilege it is to have each of you, our regular attendees, and especially our guests tonight. Thank you for being here and honoring us by worshiping the Lord with us. And thank you to our television audience. Thank you for tuning us in. But we are so blessed to be here tonight with our church sanctuary choir. And they have a wonderful musical. And I think that you will be blessed by the words of the songs, and in particular, and by the way that they are presented. These folks have worked hard. I know that you'll be blessed. And so we welcome you. We're glad you're here. And if you have any need of anything, just let one of us know, and we'll do our best to assist you. The men's and ladies' facilities are right behind the door here, or you can go out the back and down the stairs and find facilities there. But thank you for coming. Could you say good evening back to me if I say good evening to you? Let's try that. Good evening.
Good evening.
Well, let's pray together. Father, we do thank you for the time you have given us to gather together as your community of faith and to worship you in spirit and in truth. We thank you for the gift of your darling son, Jesus Christ, that arrived on that first Christmas morning. This season of Advent, we are so blessed and get a sense of the expectation and the joy that those folks had after 400 years of silence from heaven, after the roaring of the prophets. 400 years of silence, nothing from you except a promise of the coming Messiah. We have that sense tonight. We share in that just a little bit. And as we prepare our hearts spiritually, Lord, we invite you to come fully into this place tonight through the indwelling Holy Spirit of every believer that's here. May we fully allow you to express yourself to us as we surrender all to you. And as the choir sings and our musicians play, Lord, we just pray that you would use this as a message to our hearts, and that someone listening would be blessed by you, and that it bring glory to your name. We invoke your presence in this place in the powerful and sweet and holy name of Jesus. Amen. Amen. I'm going to allow you to stand up just for a minute. Not that you needed my permission, but let's greet each other, just those around you if you want to, or you can wander around for a few minutes. We'll get you back together, okay? Just say welcome to all of our guests tonight.
Thank you.
Brother Johnny.
Heavenly Father, we come to the end of another Sabbath day. Thanking you, Father, for the many blessings of life. Thank you for the freedom, the privilege we have to be here tonight. Father, we ask as we take this offering that it will be given freely and be used for the upbuilding of your kingdom. These things we do ask in your Son's name. Amen.
Peace has come, as prophets had predicted for many years. God sent himself in human form to bring peace to a chaotic world. Jesus, the Prince of Peace, reigns over a kingdom not of this world. He does not conquer oppressive rulers or topple evil empires, but he does deliver his children from the strongholds of fear and doubt and sin. Jesus' miraculous birth was just the beginning of a beautiful story of how heavenly peace has come to us. Virgin, chosen to give birth to this child, struggled to wrap her finite mind around the idea that she should soon deliver the one who would deliver us all. Her fears could only be relieved by the unseen hand of God.
Many moonless nights, cold and weary, with a babe inside, and I wonder what I've done. Holy Father, you have come and chosen me now to carry your son. As you watch my face, if a wiser one should have had my place, strong, help me.
To shepherds on earth and told them not to be afraid, for the Messiah had just been born. Their Savior, their deliverer, was just miles away. What news? And before the angels went back to heaven, they sang, "Glory to God in the highest, and with the promise of peace on earth." peace on earth is what we speak of tonight. Join us and let's sing about it together.
If you would please stand, we're going to sing together Carol Medley, okay?
It came upon the big high.
God never promised that our lives would be trouble-free. In fact, Jesus said that we definitely would have problems and heartache and pain. Jesus, just before his crucifixion, also promised to leave us with peace. My peace, he said, not as the world gives. His peace is beyond human understanding, and yet it is as real as the fear it is sent to relieve. The prophet Isaiah called it a perfect peace. Although it may seem impossible, this quiet assurance is available to those who totally trust him.
Thank you.
is not the absence of war or conflict, neither the result of a ceasefire nor the signing of a treaty. Peace is a person, Jesus Christ. We were once enemies of God because of our sin, but have been brought near to him through the blood of Christ. Now we call on him to rule in our hearts. For our comforter, our strength, our Prince of Peace has come.
Name it is the name of Jesus.
Peace has come, for our King is with us. We are so glad and so happy you joined us for worship tonight and joined in with us in singing, and we want you to come back. We invite you to come back to join us again at our regularly scheduled service times on Sunday and Sunday evening and Wednesday evening. So it's so good to have you. If you'll stand, we'll be dismissed. I want to thank our choir. What a wonderful job they have done. Go ahead and stand. Our pianist, Jane Phillips. Our organist, Gina Phillips. Acoustic guitar, Stephen Phillips. Handbells, Dana Sexton. And will our cast of characters come in? Johnny, if you'll get our cast of characters to come in here. With baby Jesus. I think the angels flew away. Here come the angels. Millie Sexton. Macy Dunlap. Where did Mary and Joseph go? That's okay. Come on in. Where's baby Jesus? Is he gone? Okay. Madison Dunlap and Evan Roberts. We are so thankful for these young people who are willing to give of their time and talents to help us out with a little drama tonight. So we're so thankful for them. Let's pray together, and then you'll be at liberty to greet one another and have a good time of fellowship afterwards, okay? Father in heaven, we are thankful for the gift of your Son, Emmanuel, God with us, God incarnate. Father, we're thankful for the hope that is only found in the Lord Jesus Christ. Father, we're thankful for the peace that passes all understanding. Father, we're thankful for the joy that you bring to us. Joy unspeakable, but yes, yet joy for us to tell others about. And Father, for your amazing love that you gave your Son to die upon a cross in our place. Father, we give you praise, we give you honor, and we give you glory, for only thou art worthy of all of our praise. Father, we're thankful for each of these gathered here tonight. Father, pray that you would watch over and care for them as we leave this evening, Father. Put a hedge of protection around each and every one. And Father, bring us back at the next appointed time to worship, to praise, to give honor and glory to you. Father, we just love you because you first loved us. And Father, that was shown in the greatest gift ever given. We praise you in Jesus' name and for his sake. Amen.